final agreement taking into account the millions of communities across Africa who are innocent victims of the impact of climate change. For such communities, a meaningful outcome entails immediate actions to address their adaptation needs. The Paris Agreement must, of essence, address the current inequalities whereby Africa has been left out on the many opportunities arising from the mitigation actions, particularly under Kyoto Protocol. Such inequalities, both in adaptation and mitigation, must be addressed so that Africa moves from the current position of a continent that suffers the most from ill effects of climate change. Our idea is to become a continent that contributes positively in the global agenda of addressing this challenge and at the same time sustaining economic and social development. Ladies and gentlemen, in this sense, the ADP process has the potential to assist African countries achieve that lofty objective. Through this process, Africa is beginning to see opportunity in the context of mitigation, although the impacts of climate change are severe. We are innovating and leading in our own way. We are committed to contributing to the agreement in accordance with our capacity and responsibility. Ladies and gentlemen, but leadership must continue to come from the industrialized nations. Apart from the support and assistance from the developed world, national efforts, robust sustainable development policies such as diversification of energy sources are important. The good and encouraging thing is that many African countries have abundant political will. It has never been wanting, and such policies and measures are already in place. In fact, Africa is playing its part by doing what it can. But because of limited means, we need the support from others so that we can do more. Ladies and gentlemen, I know at this dialogue we will have a broad discussion on a number of issues of interest, which will be the subject of high-level engagement in the work of the ADP between now and 2015. Allow me to request you to give due attention to three areas of importance in this dialogue. First, on emission reduction ambition, we need to create the dynamism in the new agreement where all governments have the incentive to continue to increase their ambition over time in accordance with the principle of the convention. It should be driven by the long-term goals and objectives of the convention. Developing regions, particularly in Africa, will need support in terms of technology, finance and skills so as to unleash the power of governments, private sector, of urban areas, local government authorities, as well as all other stakeholders. Second is on finance and other means of implementation. We need to recognize that in order to make the transition to a climate resilient and sustainable economy, we must redirect investment patterns on an unprecedented scale. This requires broad-mindedness and broad and bold approach to climate finance. Public finance will be critical, especially for adaptation action, and we must continue to scale this up and develop more effective ways to deploy resources with speed and effect. Perhaps even more important over the long term, will be effective policies and ways to diversify investment patterns. Let us explore the possibilities of involving the private sector in a more active manner. Last but not least is on the pre-2020 ambition gaps. It is important to recognize that ambition gaps exist not only in mitigation, but also in adaptation, finance, technology, and human resource development, as well as in equitable access to sustainable development. The low level of ambition of developed countries' commitments on emission reduction and provision of finance, technology, and capacity building support remain matters of grave concern. This should be given particular attention at this high level dialogue so that to inform accordingly the process between now and 2015. Excellencies and ladies and gentlemen, After those many words, it is now my singular honor and pleasure to wish all the delegates to the high-level ministerial dialogue on the Durban platform for enhanced action, very fruitful deliberations. Looking forward to good outcomes. Thank you.
Thank you, President. It's my honor now to introduce two eminent ministers.